Hello.
Hi, Lana.
Hey, Lana.
Hi, Lana, babe.
Hey, everybody.
Hello, guys.
Hi, Lana.
How are you?
Lana, my baby girl, my one and only, my number one slot.
It's great to see you all as well. What have you been up to since the show?
Life's been good.
I have been on a few dates since the show. Let me tell you that, because I wanted to put that into practice, I'm telling you.
I've been working, back in the ring, boxing shows, MMA shows, my absolute heart and joy.
Everything's real good.
I went and did a bit of travelling. I ended up getting stuck in Thailand.
But I created a new company and I've been putting all my time and effort into making that a success.
Wow, I'm impressed. So, are you all still friends?
I speak to almost everyone from the show, to be honest.
I'm still close to so many people from the show.
I speak to everyone. We still have our group chat. Everyone's still very active in the group chat.
Which I titled, Lana is Bae.
Oh, stop it, you.
Bryce was FaceTiming me yesterday.
David, Matthew, Kels and I, we went to Vegas together.
Come on.
It was just such a great time.
We're a family, basically.
It's quite impossible not to carry on speaking to them people that you lived with for like a whole month. The one person I speak to the most is Nicole. She's literally my bestie.
We are going to get an apartment together. We're going to move in.
She has helped me through so many ups and downs in this past year, and I can't thank her enough.
Friendship like that, when you have that instant bond, is so special, and I'm very lucky to have her in my life.
Is anyone more than friends?
I mean, I do have a special someone. Unfortunately, it's not Sharon.
Oh.
We kind of fell off a little bit. We took a break in our communication.
I'm sorry, guys.
To drop a little bit of a bomb on you guys. I have a little bit of a long-distance thing going with Nicole, believe it or not.
I really bonded with him with casually seeing where it's going to go.
I hope to get her back out here, or me out there.
Anyone else?
I don't know if I'm allowed to talk about Harry, but me and Harry have been amazing as well. Oh, I do have a matching tattoo with Harry. We got matching lightning bolts.
Very cute.
Next, I'm going to get his name right across my forehead.
Not so cute.
Me and Francesca are planning on moving in together, so.
Oh, you love birds.
COVID happening right now. We can't live in the same country, but we're just waiting for this to be over so we can do that.
So, about isolation, how are you finding it?
Being on the retreat and not being able to hook up with Harry there has prepared me for being stuck at my house without him.
You know, I don't have a swimming pool, don't have the sea, don't have amazing, like, bunch of people around me. And I think that's one thing that is missing from this lockdown kind of quarantine environment.
I have literally binge-watched the season Too Hot to Handle twice.
You're not the only one, Chloe. What about the rest of you?
Well, I've just been trying to stay busy.
Just allow me to be more reflective. I spend a lot of time reading books.
I'd rather be on the boat than pretty much anywhere else.
Me too, Bryce. Me too. Who would you most like to be quarantined with?
I would definitely choose Harry as my isolation partner. Me and him literally are just like on the same energetic level. We'd be like, bing, 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 bing. We'd be bouncing off the walls together. Oh my God, it'd be so fun.
I can't choose a single person from the cast that I want to be in quarantine with, but we did actually talk about this. I did send everyone a message in the group thread and said, how cool would it be if we were all in quarantine together? Like, wouldn't this be amazing? And everyone was agreeing with me. I don't, however, think it would be a good idea if Lana wasn't there, because it could very quickly turn into an extremely sexual situation.
And we definitely don't want that. Last question, everyone. What were your favorite moments from the retreat?
I mean, there was a lot of great moments.
When I found out I actually had a backbone, that moment was just magical for me.
Is that muggy, yes or no, Corey?
Me and 13 brand new people and just getting to know them.
So, would you do it all again?
If I could do the experience again, I definitely would. I had the best time of my life in Mexico. I mean, sun, sand, the nicest, most fun, inspiring people, and I made some money.
Yes, girl.
I've gained so much and I've moved forward quite a lot.
I've literally grown so much in such a short amount of time.
I met some of the most amazing people in my entire life, and I created the most amazing memories.
And it has had a huge positive impact on my life.
I'm so happy to hear that. Talk to you soon.
I'll talk to you again, Lana, you little soap.
Lovely speaking with you, Lana.
Thank you. I love you guys.
Mwah.